Well, it looks as if my potion is coming along quite nicely. I suspect I'll get another perfect score on this exam. Well, I think we should add just a little bit more frog legs. Wingardium Leviosa. There we are. And stir it just a bit more. Perfect. Oh. Well, look who decided to wake up. Where are we? We're in potions class. And you've been asleep for the past 20 minutes. No, don't worry, we've been assigned to the same team, so I've been doing all the work as per usual. Well, that's because Harry and Ron already chose each other as teammates over there. So, it's just us two. Yes, I know. Well, we're about halfway done. And it is coming along exactly as it should. Oh, you want to help? Then why on earth didn't you take a nap? Well, I guess better late than never. Okay. Well, there's only about 10 more steps. And I just have to take a few more notes on the color and the aroma before we proceed, so I know which direction we want to go in. What kind of potion? You really didn't pay attention, did you, in the beginning? It's a sleepiness potion. Potion of relaxation. Yes, exactly. Which you don't need any of, I don't think. Well, let me just take some notes. No, no, I can do this. Dear, I need more ink. Okay. So it is a What do you smell? Rosemary? Very good. Well, let's see. Well, we have to turn in a report with the potion. Yes, Snape is very particular. Okay, well, I think I have the notes for now. Since you're awake, you want to help me, yes? Great. Okay. Let's just leave that there for now. So, the next step, let me read my book here, is bark. Bark of the Weeping Willow. Was quite a pain to acquire, if you can imagine. But we've got it, so add it. It actually smells quite nice. Okay. There. And then let's just stir it. Would you like to stir a little? Oh, perfect. That's enough. Quite enough. Thank you. Okay, so I have quite a few ingredients left to add. You have to shake this one up. Do you know what it is? Yes. Goblin snot. Do you want to do the honors? No? Okay. Just 3 drops of this. There. Perfect. And then let's wait just a moment. Just let it settle. That looks about right. Next, we have a little bit of fairy juice. Isn't that a silly name? So what were you doing that kept you up so late last night? Ah, well, that makes sense. Well, I'm glad you managed to get a bit of shut-eye. I actually enjoy doing most of this on my own, if I'm quite honest. It's like nobody else can do it right but me, I feel sometimes. Anyway. We have to add a couple of eye of newts. It's quite macabre. But I think this should be quite enough. There. And then 4 salamander teeth. Now these were quite hard to acquire as well. I swear Snape enjoys making us use the most difficult ingredients possible. Three and four. There. Okay, so let me just check my book here. You want to see what the remaining ingredients are, I suppose. Well, we have some dead sea salt here. Even muggles use this, along with some lavender. Lavender is my favorite smell. It's quite nice. And of course, we have a little bit of cloud essence. This needs to be shaken every couple minutes to ensure that it doesn't get too thick. There we go. Of course, the hardest ingredient of all to acquire. I had Harry help me with this one a little bit. But dragon's blood. So we're only going to add 1/2 drop of this. Any more and it would... They say that the fumes are enough to kill everybody in the room. Like I said, Snape does not like to play around. And then, of course, just some rat bones. Well, it's probably time to add the essence of cloud, so I'm going to put a few drops. Turning the color and fizzing just right. It looks excellent. Snot. It's quite liquidy, isn't it? Oof. Four drops of this. One, two, three, four. There we are. Okay. Let's just let it settle in for a bit. Dead sea salt. Shake it up a little bit. Now this you can touch. We just want one about this big. Ah! There we are. I do think that my favorite potion, or my favorite ingredient, sorry, is cloud essence. It's just so pretty. Then just a little bit of fairy juice. Why is it called fairy juice? Why, it's from squeezed out fairies. Fairies drink. It's quite sweet, like nectar. All right. There. Now I'm going to stir it for a little bit, unless you would like to. I understand. Never really seen you around. Do you keep to yourself mostly? Ah. I probably would too if it weren't for Harry and Ron dragging me around everywhere. Nothing really beats a good book. Just curled up by yourself reading it, huh? This is a potion that Snape concocted that he's giving us a bit of. I said exactly one drop. There. And then just check the book one more time. Add the drop of fairy's blood, then the fairy juice, and exactly four drops of that. And step 1, step 2, step 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. So step 8. Good. And the step 10. I think we're doing quite well. And looks like. Kind of quickly. It's supposed to get a bit thicker. Ah, perfect. Well, I do think that it's time to add a little bit of the lavender. So, let's just sprinkle a little bit of that in. The color's coming. We wait for just another moment, okay? With a little bit of stirring every 4 minutes or so. There. Now we have this, which is just a classic. Own base for a potion. Okay. Perfect. Let's stir it just a bit more. It's looking quite nice. scales. And we should add and there we go. I do believe we're going to add another newt eye. So let's go ahead and put this in there. Okay, let me read this book there. Okay. Beautiful. Let me just we have essence of cat. So just there. And a bit. Now, this isn't in the textbook, but I did a little bit of experimenting on my own, and I found that adding some of the parts that grow in the forbidden forest right off the trees on the center, on the edge. So if you just add the entire pod, well, yes, it reduces the boiling time by up to 2 hours. So I think that Professor Snape let's store it just a bit more. We've done very good today. You can resume your nap, I suppose.